Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
I'm Noella.
Happy birthday, dear Noella.
Birthdays are always a big part of my life. A chance for my family and I to come together.
Say thank you.
But there's sometimes sadness alongside the celebrations.
Kitu mimi, najua nikigrow up, nilikuwa na believe. Like mimi, nilikuwa najua chizi, ni msee mwenye. Mase huu msee amekunywa drugs. Ajitakipoa kwa maisha yake. Na ameamua withdraw away.
In my country, Kenya, a staggering 1 in 4 people who seek healthcare have a mental health condition.
Missing it. It is a cake, it is not alive.
People with lived experience with mental illness are often locked up rather than treated. And around 3,000 people die by suicide every year.
Na mimi ni msick, sijui ya drugs. Niko na mental illness, lakini sijui ya drugs. Lakini sasa mimi, ndio huyo chizi wasi usema.
Noella?
Imagine it is already noon and you are still sleeping.
Noella is going to be a star. Because she will get cured. And her dream is going to be valid. That's my prayer.
This is my life right now. I've been diagnosed with bipolar disorder. I don't fully know what it means, but one thing I keep experiencing is not being able to distinguish what is reality and what isn't. And I find myself forgetting things. That's why I'm recording this. Maybe it will eventually lead me to understand what's happening to me.
It wasn't always like this. I have always loved to tell stories. My first subjects were my family, my father, my mother, and my two elder brothers. I would record anything around me. I even got a job with a local TV show making documentaries. As I find out how real I love to tell stories about people, life, and adventure. This became my chosen path.
Mtazamaji, Noella huyu ni mwandishi, mwanahabari, mtayarishi wa filamu.
Kama mimi ni documentary filmmaker, ili kuweza kutumia mbinu ambazo ninazo kuhamasisha jamii kuhusu.
Then all my dreams came true. I got a scholarship to study filmmaking in the US. I embraced it. I embraced all the things that came my way. School, friends. I even got a job at the school's production company. I knew I had adjusted pretty fast. But then there was a feeling I could never quite shake off. It never quite felt like home. Things were different. The people, the culture, food. I started to withdraw little by little from everyone and everything. I felt very alone. One day I woke up excited. I wanted to make a feast for my family. It was going to be the biggest party ever. I called them saying how excited I was that they were coming to see me. No one was coming. There was no party. I was all by myself. Everything just stopped. Everything went blank. This was my first manic episode. I woke up in a psych ward in North Carolina. They didn't tell me what was wrong. They released me, but things would never be the same. In less than a week or so, I was back in hospital. I quit school and came back home.
I'm now stuck at home, struggling, really struggling to work. I find myself spending time with this guy and watching YouTube videos.
And only 0.7% of hospitals provide mental health care services in the country.
People are so afraid and shy of indicating that they are human beings who suffer from, say, depression or schizophrenia or PTSD, that they would rather stay with their illnesses at home.
So imagine living half of your life
chained to a bed or to a tree because you have a mental illness. Well, this was the reality for a 52-year-old man who lived with schizophrenia, which is a severe form of mental illness, since he was 15 years old.
483 people died of suicide within the last 3 months, a worrying trend that cycles us back to the conversation around mental wellness and care.
I feel that the only time that people like me are recognized or seen is when things go horribly wrong. It's only when people are having a relapse or suicidal, and it breaks me. It really, really does.
In Kenya, people with mental illness often find themselves discriminated against. As it stands now, the Kenyan Constitution singles out people of unsound mind, a very vague term that is used to victimize people like me. It's used to deny us a voice to stand for our rights. Together with our families, we are left to figure things out behind closed doors. My family has always been religious and turned to the church in times of crisis.
In the name of the Father and of the Son.
I grew up attending Sunday school.
The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit.
My mom ensured that my brothers and I started Catholic sacraments, like baptism and confirmation. For my crisis, we turned to the church once again.
Behold, I'd like to say something.
Please do.
We really wanted this together with Noella. She got another attack, a second one. And it was a revelation to us as a family. So we really wanted it. A lot of people have been against it. So we thank you for coming. Thank you.
Oh. Yes. Yes.
Now you are at home. I've never cried about my condition. I've never cried about this.
Yes.
Cry now.
Cry it out. Yes.
Psalms 23.
The Lord is a shepherd.
Bless her, Father.
The Lord and staff comfort you. The bread of us is born in the presence of our friends. The Lord and the Lord comfort you. For the goodness of us is
I can see the hurt in my family's eyes. They strongly believe that God will work it out. I'm afraid to tell them it may take more than just that.
I want to give you a glimpse into my world. Well, I have just woken up. It's 4 p.m. heading, well, it's a minute to 5. Am I embarrassed? It's my medication that makes me not know the days. So I'll have a full night's rest and still have enough to sleep during the day. And it's frustrating because you want to be productive, but your medication doesn't allow you to be productive. Yeah, welcome to my world. The burn. Let me check.
But I'm not better.
Come and do it.
You're not better.
Come and do it. Try.
I'm lazy.
Na skia nimechoka. Not as you didn't skip for long. Niko unfit. Ati nimedo it haraka. Sasa nili tripoliwa dawa.
Fat bambula.
Really?
Fat bambula.
You see fat bambula. Niko healthy vizuri.
But this one was also very
thin. Ah, huyo ameincrease. Hiyo hata yaka ni
but bambula. You, club.
Have you noticed that I've gained weight?
A lot of it.
And you didn't tell me.
Ladies are never told about their weight. Because you don't want to fight.
You don't want to fight. I've gained a lot of it and you're not telling me.
But I know one thing is the drugs.
Yes.
So, I'm not a doctor to say I will control that.
Put on the condition to skip. Yes, you can. Come, I show you. Then.
So you are stretched.
Then, that is it.
You only move your legs towards where your hands are.
Noella was a normal girl. She grew up like just all the other kids that I have.
I experienced a bit of mental illness with my late father-in-law, Noella's grandpa, and did not give it much attention. Not until now I experienced a bit of it with my own daughter. It's disturbing. You can see somebody is sick, but cannot express how he is feeling.
Nai.
Which one?
Oh, you. Can you look at the
matter?
I put it in the matter. I want an idea. Come on, you could want me. That's an album.
Follow the instructions of the doctor. And with the time, you see a miracle from your creator, because he created you for a purpose. Then there you are. The Noella we used to know has now changed.
Change is not the easiest thing to accept, especially when you never planned for it. My life had changed and I needed to adapt and try to find my own path. I knew I wasn't alone. There are probably others like me out there going through the same thing. Rather than hiding my problems, I decided to be open about them.
So I'm starting this project and I don't know how to go about it.
I posted a video sharing my experiences on different WhatsApp groups. And soon enough, I found my tribe. A support group of others who are also open about what they were going through.
So, like, maybe you can say, hey, my name is Phyllis. I'm passionate about sexual abuse and mental health issues.
So do you like the rule of thirds?
Look at the headspace. Yes, that's fine.
Many people are suffering in silence, not knowing where to seek help. I think now I'm safe.
You're not set? Is it now? Do you feel like it's therapy for you to speak about your story?
It is, but every time you speak or write, you feel it is therapeutic. You feel a change anyway.
Everyone gets to film themselves and gets to film others.
Mzazi anaweza mlaumu kwa kuwa yeye ndiye amejitoroi, lakini hakujua ni nini kilikuwa na.
Nice job! Yeah!
You did great.
You did great. Thank you for being the first one.
So are you ready?
Yes, madam.
3, 2, 1.
Hello. My name is Nicholas Odhiambo Osir, and I am a mental health survivor. And I'm also a mental health advocate, and I am a philosopher. 3 years ago, I was diagnosed with multiple mental illnesses. These are depression, depressive psychosis, induced psychosis, and bipolar. I really lost my closest friends and some of my family members. What I needed most was the closeness of people to me.
I hadn't anticipated the significance of Nick and my personal journey to discover what's it in my mind.
I was a hope within the whole community, you know, to become a priest. So I went to Colombia and I stayed there for around some very few time. Unfortunately, I got depression. I couldn't even open up for my family members because I knew that How will my people take me?
Nick became my friend. We share the pain of feeling like we let our families down. Like me, he had the opportunity to go abroad and also came back home with nothing. That's not an easy pill to swallow. Like many Kenyans, she didn't have access to any meaningful support and took extreme measures to try and keep Nick safe.
Kuru natuwe kale mukai. Nia, ya kuaruni. E mano cha kinyinge. Ma Nicholas. Ma Nicholas ma basi. Ya kugwe de. Kugwe de kuru natuwe ka. Kuru anu no grupu doma. Achaka go.
Nora. Nora. Nora.
Kuru nalu no nyalupu do. Nyanya sakutoa hii kitu. Chaka gole, kura gine kama.
Gine strong nyanya.
Do not take it. Kura beta beta kwa rekanu, kura betka to betka.
I think the problem with our systems a lot of times is, can you get place where somebody is genuinely ready to assist you? That is the bottom line. For the family,
you have to be vulnerable for you to get that help.
Meaning?
You have to accept that there's a problem.
Yes, but you see, exactly, and you see now, that's also started, right? The family itself, I think it starts with the people around you. How they take this. Are they ashamed of it? And the minute they're ashamed of it, you'll also get ashamed of it yourself. And therefore, no movement. So it's all the people around you.
It's having the patience to accept that it's a lifelong journey. That's the thing. And not everyone has that.
Fortunately.
Yeah.
Fortunately. And that's why I wish we could get
some. So there's the issue of affordability.
Yes, and medication is not cheap. Getting the right doctor is not cheap. For us, I think we are lucky because where I go to Kamili, they don't charge me to see the doctor and for counseling.
Suppress the negatives, uplift the positive. To me, that's the philosophy of life. That's how you move on.
Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear Noella.
Happy birthday, girl.
Boy, my brother, I'm a cowboy. Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
May you have many more. May you live to blow. Many, many candles.
May all the ways ahead of you be opened by the Holy Spirit so that you do the will of God.
Amen!
With each new year comes hope for a new beginning. But this next one was going to be like no other.
Happy birthday to
you. Indeed, it is clear that now Kenya is squarely in the grip of this pandemic. There shall be a cessation of all movement until otherwise notified.
In Kenya and around the world, the COVID pandemic brought increased stress and anxiety. It is even harder to deal with for those who already have a mental illness.
With COVID, I'm just noticing that I'm a bit low. So mom and my family are very supportive and I'm thankful for that. But sometimes I don't know whether they understand me. I don't know, when I say that sometimes I'm low or I don't have energy, I'm really, really, really praying that I will be off meds, because of the side effects of the medication.
Oh, Nick, sama. Ukona line bill. Nisikuwa sijakuwa nikisikia poa. Domana ni menyamaza. How are you? Uh-huh. You had relapse. Sasa unajoli niambia, you wanted to see whether you can go and see the doctor. Uli manage kuenda kumuona? Okay. But dawa sasa zimekusaidia ama? Dawa zimekusaidia? Okay. People are really struggling.
I've come 1 month early. Dawa inanilemea kidogo.
Hebu niambie kukulemea in
what? I really struggle mchana.
Kulala?
Mm.
Ama unalala zaidi? Una struggle to stay awake?
To stay awake. Even waking up, it's a struggle. Mm.
When we look at the dosage, the dosage is not very high.
Mm-hmm.
I ask you to stop medication and then you're always in and out of hospital. So I'd rather for you to be on medication.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Na siku njema.
Oh, yeah.
Muoge mkono, hatutaki corona.
Sawa.
Okay, asante sana.
Karibu sana.
Haya, siku njema.
While I was still trying to adjust to my medication, I got some unexpected news about Nick.
Nilikuwa nakuuliza utakuja
Uko mali uko?
Mimi, eh. Ali mimi uko bado hatujui. Ndio na find out pole pole. Huyo babake alisema hizi ambia mtu yeyote.
I was worried about Nick. We hadn't been able to get through to him on his phone. Then we heard that he was being held by a religious group. His father took him after a manic episode. He believed they could heal him. We waited for them to give us permission to see him. We prayed and hoped that he was okay. A few weeks later, we saw a news report showing where Nick was being held and demonstrating his so-called treatment.
Chance, his mind is resting. I'm the one who produces his spiritual power. It's the power that is doing this.
I accompanied his grandmother and sister to see him, but was nervous about how he might be.
Yeah, it's a chance. They are quite many lucky.
No,
no. How have you been? Long time, eh?
But I have
been
under
corona.
Oh, yeah, we have been praying for you. No, she's missed you. I came to see you.
You know, remember, for you to come back in this room is very. You will talk longer than that. So that's why I know I should. Because I met with you first. I know my dad will get time.
No, talk to her. Talk to her.
Yeah. You smart or calm?
Hey, to me, you let her. You remember when I took her juice? Kasama chipo. Kakuku.
Chipo is inside. Chipo. You're very smart, huh? And you're amazing, sir.
I was so happy to see him healthy. To see him smile. But he's chained all day and every day. He will stay like this until they cast out the demon, which is his mental illness. Why would they do this? In the name of what? God? This is a reality of how mental health is often dealt with in my country. Why would God allow this? Seeing Nick has also made me think about my own health.
Kitu mimi, najua nikigrow up, nilikuwa na believe. Like mimi, nilikuwa najua chizi, ni mse mwenye. Aze umse amekunywa drugs, ajitakipoa kwa maisha yake, na ameamua withdraw away. Lakini sasa mimi, ndio huyo chizi wasi usema. Na mimi ni msik, si juu ya drugs. Niko na mental illness, lakini si juu ya drugs. Si vile, si kulogwa juu, ase, ni ugonjwa. Lakini si kila mtu anaelewa ni ugonjwa, si kila mtu ana believe.
I had another manic episode. I have to lift myself despite all that's going on. We just learned that my mother is unwell. She got a late diagnosis of stage 4 colon cancer. I keep thinking, this is not the time to worry about myself.
Thank you.
Sasa.
Niko.
Karibu sana.
Mungu ni mwema.
Yeah. Sabo.
I have to be there for her in every way that I can. The same way she has always been there for me.
Where were you now? You need to take it seriously. For Zingin, I think I'm meant to make you rest.
Feeling today?
Slightly better.
You're even walking. That's good news. Mom never favored anybody. It did not matter who it was. It did not matter how much or how little she knew about you. She opened so many doors. And in the process, she helped us learn how to open doors for other people as well.
I want to inform you that Noella was admitted in hospital last evening, but she's doing well, and I will be getting back to them later in the day to find out how she has done, but I just wanted to inform you that at least she's there so that you don't worry, she doesn't get in touch with you. Yeah.
I'm Noella, the girl with the eyes. I'm just here being vain, looking at myself. So life has just been kicking my ass real, real bad. Wow, my dearest mother went to be with the Lord. Wow, it's 1 month and a few days later, and it's hard. It really is hard. The last few days, I've been dreaming a lot about her. I can't spend a day without thinking about her. I'm grateful that I got to spend a lot of time with her, especially after her retirement and working on the film. I'm just part of a story, and I'm trying to slowly get back to, you know, get back to work and doing stuff. Yeah, so today I got this look.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Noella. Happy birthday to you.
Part of coping is about being resilient, especially when having to live with an invisible illness. I have to accept that coping with my illness may be a lifelong journey. But it's not just for me. There's one more person I really want to catch up with.
Hi. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. And you?
I'm okay.
I've missed you so much.
Nick spent a year and a half with the religious group.
We were worried. We didn't know where you were. We tried to call.
My sister Veronica, my grandmom, they lost hope of where I was. And in fact, I just think and sense that perhaps they even thought that I was actually dead. Yes.
So you're actually missing for some time. And we didn't know how we would find you.
Finally free from his chains, Nick can now look to the future.
I've gone through such a hard time, but here you are.
Of course.
Here you are.
And that is why we say, let us give hope to people. Let us normalize conversing on mental health matters. Let us not remain in silence. Let us talk. Just try to ignite that conversation on mental health.
The reality of mental health is not imagined. Many of us continue to suffer in silence. Until the abuse stops, we are unshackled, and our rights upheld, we have to keep going.